Hey, what's up? This is a quick update on the Underglow lights I've been building for my brother's Menti's RC car. I'm using an Arduino Nano and a WS2812B light strip. And the plan is to install the lights just under the car's removable chassis. I ran into a bit of a problem that I need to troubleshoot, and I thought I'd show you what's going on, but I'll catch you up with where I'm at in the project first. If you follow me, you're probably aware I've been making some shorts with theme music demonstrating some of the examples that come with the FastLED library that I'm using to drive the light strip. I also just put out a 58-second crash course tutorial on how to get the hardware set up and how to load the Twinkle Fox example to do this yourself. It was fast. Very fast. It might make your brain melt. I'll put a card above and a link in the description if you want to check it out. I'm making a couple longer tutorials as well, one for absolute beginners and one for those who are already familiar with Arduino. So keep an eye out for it so you don't miss it. It helps if you hit that subscribe button over there. But because I'm doing separate tutorials specifically for using the light strip with Arduino, I'm not going to focus so much on that here, other than an overview of what I've modified or added in from those tutorials. Okay, here's the breadboard prototype of what I'm planning to install in the car. Really, the only hardware change I've made from that short tutorial is adding in a momentary push button so we can switch between different lights or patterns. I've attached it to pin 3 on the Nano, and I've initialized that pin to use the internal pull-up resistor so it's active low, so the button is switching to ground. I'll be adding battery leads on the ground and VIN pins as well when I put this on a prototype PCB board, since I intend to run this off of rechargeable batteries. I could splice in wires from the batteries in the RC car to power the Arduino and lights, but I'm opting to keep this modular so it can be removed and used elsewhere if desired. Anyway, because I'm using lithium-ion batteries, I need to use a built-in voltage regulator of the VIN pin on the Arduino Nano to step down the voltage from 7.4 volts to 5 volts. When I build this on a PCB, I'll be supplying the light strip with 5 volts from the 5-volt pin of the Arduino. Because we're supplying our lights through the Arduino, I've left the max amp setting in the program set to 500 milliamps like I've got set up here since we're using USB power. The Revision 3 Arduino Nano 5-volt pin can put out up to 800 milliamps, so we should be good there. The batteries are 14500 lithium-ion 800 mAh batteries. According to the datasheet, the 800 mAh is given at a 0.2C rating. This means if you draw 160 milliamps from them, they should last about 5 hours. Their max discharge rating is at 1C though, so they can put out up to 800 mAh. They just won't last nearly as long. I may upgrade to 18650 batteries to last longer, or even add on a higher rated external regulator so we can turn the brightness up more at some point, but for now, I'm just using what I've got on hand. Okay, let's use some Presto Paul magic to move this breadboard to a circuit board. Magic! Too bad I can't do that with my finger. Stay away from those koala bears, guys, they bite. Alright, so the circuit is exactly the same as I had on the breadboard, except I've added in the leads from the battery box. I've added in some connectors too to make the lights and power easily swappable. I'll try to get all the stuff that I'm using in the description for you. Now, the circuit works, kind of. I'll show you what's happening though. Sometimes when I turn it on, it'll cycle through all the patterns I have programmed in there currently, which I'll show you in a moment, but then it'll freeze up and become unresponsive. Sometimes I can't even cycle through them all before it freezes up. What the heck? Before I postulate and theorize about what I think is going on, let's walk through the code quick so you have the full picture. Eventually, when the project's all done, I'll put the code up on GitHub or my website. So if you watch my really fast tutorial, you'll notice a lot of the defines from that tutorial are the exact same, like the numleds, data pin 2, color order, chipset, brightness. All that's the same as my quick tutorial, but there are a couple things I added in, like this button pin here, since I added on a push button, toggle value. So when I'm using my push button, I set a variable called toggle value. And so every time I push the push button, it just increments this toggle value to a different value. And then I'm using if statements in my code to swap between each of my light programs, basically. So when I first power up the program, I'm setting my toggle value equal to 0, so that's going to set my lights to green, which is what they are right now. And so if I hit the button again, it'll change my toggle value to 1, which will change it to blue, and toggle value 2 changes it to red. So that's kind of how I'm implementing the push button. I'm just using a toggle variable that keeps count. And other than that, I've got my little check button function here set up. I've got that defined in the bottom. And I'm using a software to bounce. Every time you're using a push button, guys, you're going to probably want to use a debounce, some sort of debounce. You can do that in hardware. You can use a 555 timer to do a debounce, or you could use a resistor or resistor and a capacitor to do a hardware debounce. But yeah, you're going to want to use a debounce, and I got that set up here. So in a software debounce, it's basically just using a delay setting. So when you push the button, it's implementing a little delay to make sure that you actually mean to push the push button. So when you first push the push button, it doesn't actually sense that it's pushed for like 50 milliseconds or however long I had that set. I've got last debounce time and debounce delay. So I got it set to 70 milliseconds right now. So it has to be pushed for 70 milliseconds so it knows that you actually intend to push the put button. Intend to push the push button. Got it. Oh, yes. But yeah, I'm also using the input pull-up resistor. Arduino has a built-in pull-up resistor, which I'm using. So that just, it keeps my input high whenever I'm not pushing the push button, so it doesn't have those little ghost fluctuations and thinks it gets pushed when it's not actually getting pushed. So between that and the debounce that I'm using, just makes my button work good. So I'm pretty sure the problem isn't with the code or the lights, since they work just fine on the breadboard. One thing I'm thinking might have happened is that I accidentally shorted the light strip to something on the circuit board. When I first built this, I picked it up and moved it, not remembering that these little tabs between each of the lights is just uncovered bare metal. These strips are meant to be cut to length and soldered onto, which is why they're bare like that. Operator error. That's my theory right now, anyway. I think the Nano board might have been damaged. Another piece of evidence to suggest this is that the built-in reset button on the Nano doesn't work either when it freezes up. So that's probably where I'll start. I'll stick another Nano board in and see if that fixes it. I'll do some basic ohm checks around it too before I do that, just to make sure there aren't any shorts anywhere in the wiring or soldering. Don't want to ruin another board if that's the case. Let me know in the comments what else could be doing this. It's always fun to practice troubleshooting. I'll get back to you in the next video about what I find. All that's left really is getting these lights installed in the car and then going to the racetrack and racing it and seeing how it looks on the track. The lights I plan to put in the car are these waterproof lights. They're still 5 volt WS2812B lights, but the length of the strip is coated in this thick clear rubber. No short circuits with this light strip. For some reason though, the connectors were installed on different sides of this light strip, so I'll have to fix that too, I guess. I'm also planning to design and 3D print a container for the circuit board to keep water away from that as well. And just a disclaimer, I'm not that good at 3D design. I get frustrated. It'll probably be entertaining. You should subscribe so you don't miss it. Okay, smash that like button if you enjoyed this video. I'll see you in the next one. This is Life Meet Lightning, bringing a little lightning into your life.